What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. You guys, in today's video, I'm going to simply, and I wasn't even planning on cutting this video today at all, but I was going through my news feed here a second ago and I'm like, bam, there's a post I need to talk about. So this video is for real estate agents that are out there posting open houses, posting your listings, and just doing phenomenal jobs with content. This video is for you guys. I'm going to kind of just show you how to clean it up a little bit. And how the flow should go to capture leads and to get appointments. So this video is for those of you that are not capturing leads, and I'm going to show you kind of an example of posts that do not really capture leads. And again, I'm going to show you how to kind of fix it. Okay, so if you're new, stay subscribed, follow me here on Facebook, follow me on YouTube, because I'm going to keep putting out more videos on social media marketing and Facebook advertising for real estate agents. Okay, so here's what I wanted to show you. And this is again just what came into my news feed a few seconds ago. And I'm like, dude, let me just talk about this real quick. Let me help out Stephanie. Let me help out Stephanie. Shout out to Stephanie, one of my Facebook friends over here. Shout out to Stephanie, hustling, doing her damn thing, right? Posting her listings and really, really crushing it. But here's kind of how you want to crush it online. Okay, Stephanie. And to again, all of you realtors that are posting listings like this and links like this, right? So today's video is really all about the back end, the link. When people click, where are you taking them, right? That's the million-dollar question. When people click, where are you taking them? So in here, you guys, the text, right? Just breaking down the text. This Mariners Cove home is looking for you. Home is being offered turnkey. Yes, the golf cart too, for 250, right? Mariners Cove is a widely popular 55 plus. Okay, cool. Want to take a peek? Contact me today. Okay, so here's the problem with organic posting, you guys. Here's the problem with organic posting. Stephanie is a friend of mine on Facebook over here. I'm in California. She is in Fort Myers. Okay, so she's in Florida. I'm in California. Now, maybe her whole strategy is to attract people who are relocating. Okay, that's one strategy, I guess, to capture people that are relocating. So if that is your marketing strategy and you guys are taking clients from wherever the hell they're coming from across the country, then cool. That's an actual marketing strategy. And so that type of a person would be posting all the time on every platform: Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest, freaking TikTok. Every platform you're posting every day, because your whole objective is to capture the attention of anyone and everyone, right? That's what happens organically. So as we scale up our friend count, Stephanie's at 1,000 friends. As she takes that 1,000, well, shit, once she passed 300, those were already people that she didn't know. So from 300 to 1,000, I'm willing to bet those 700 people are people just like me who are friends with Stephanie, but are nowhere in the market. We don't know her. We don't even live in the state. I'm willing to bet that's 700 of the 1,000. As she goes from 1,000 to 2,000 to 3,000 to 4,000 friends on Facebook, these people are not going to be nowhere in the area. They're going to be people just like me who are across the country that are just simply requesting random people to become friends with. So if that is your market, you guys, randoms, people that live across the country that are nowhere interested at all, you got a few thousand people following you on Instagram. You got a few thousand people following you on TikTok. You got a few thousand people connected with you on LinkedIn. You got a few thousand friends over here on Facebook. And every single one of them, you guys, well, let's just call it 99%. 99% of any friend list, these are people who don't live in the area and are not in your market whatsoever. So when you're posting organically like this, it's like I'm seeing it in the news feed and it doesn't resonate with me one iota. And I'm willing to bet it doesn't resonate with the 700 plus that are also in my category of living across the country. We don't know Stephanie. We're nowhere in the market. We're just random friends, right? And again, this applies to any platform. It's all the same. So that's why I'm not really an organic guy. Like, I'd rather just run an ad. Like, so in this case, again, the text, what you want to be doing here is rather than contact me today and click the link below. Okay, so the link is there for sure, right? But rather than, so let me rephrase that. You can get away with putting contact me and And because she put the word click the link, that's the game changer. That's the game changer. But as I click the link, here's what's going on. And here's what literally 99%. And I don't mean to keep using that big number, but that is what it is, you guys. I have 5,000 friends over here on Facebook, and every single one of them is an agent. So I've been seeing this for years. 99.9% of realtors, when they're marketing their open houses and listings, I'm clicking on the link and they're bringing me to the MLS link. They're bringing me to this page, right? Where it has all the information on the property, which you would think is a good thing, right? You're giving up all this information on the property, but nowhere on here is there a form for me to fill out. Nowhere on here is there a form for me to put my name and email, right? Am I missing it? There's nothing here. But even if there was a little form over here to the right, because that's what I also see, I'll click and then there'll be like a little form over here tucked in under here on the right-hand side. But after giving up all this information, it's like, man, why do I need to opt in anymore, right? I'll just automatically think, okay, well, that's not the property for me and I'll move on. But had you have taken them to a simple landing page where they can at least opt in, right? Maybe the property's not for them at all, but hey, that's someone that opted in. You just captured a lead. Sending them to a page like this, there's no lead capture, you guys. So if you're sending them to an MLS link, or if you're sending them to your fancy website, Coldwell, KW, your Realty One fancy website, that's not the answer either. So if you guys, so again, not just Stephanie, she's not the only one guilty. It's everyone. Like, let me take you to a group that I have. This is a private group that I have, just 4,500 real estate agents in this group right here, and everyone posts their listings and open houses, right? So right here, 2.34 acres, shout out to Dorica. Right here, she's going down. There's the text. But there's nowhere to capture the lead, right? There's nowhere. There's no link, right? So all we're waiting on here is for people to comment. Maybe someone might direct messenger. But when you're just posting, you guys, randomly, organically, again, it's being seen by people that are nowhere in your audience, like at all. Okay, so that's that. Let me go down to an actual page where I can find a link. So here's a listing. Here's all the text. There's no link. Actually, she has, for more information, look, okay, cool. Perfect example right here. I click on the link. She's taking me to her full-blown website, right? So so if you guys do have a link and I click on it, this is where 99.9% of you guys are taking us, to a full-blown website, to your actual broker, your brokerage website, right? The problem with that, many, many problems here, is that, again, it's too informative. So just like the other one, she gave up all this information before she ever asked for mine, right? Too informative. Over here, this website, too informative. All of a sudden, right? If she was running ads, shout out to Lene, is that how you pronounce it? Shout out to her. But this is not the page to advertise, because it's just too informative and there's too much. The contact form is way down here. It wasn't even the first thing that we saw at all, right? There's just too much going on. My listing, search, about me. That's problem number one. Problem number one about these fancy websites is that there's too much information, it's too informative, and there's too many distractions. Before you know it, people are clicking on resources, they're going to a farm ranch, they're looking over here under open houses, and then you're gone. So that's problem number one. You cannot take them to a full-blown website anymore. Not in 2023 and beyond, if you're trying to post organically, or even if you're running ads on social media. If you're trying to build your business on social media, it's not these fancy websites anymore, okay? None of the fancy websites. But then again, that's problem number one. It's the fancy website. Problem number two is the fact that, again, I don't mean to keep using 99%, but it's damn near 99.9999% of the time when I click on these links, and I could show you a million of them, you guys. I can keep scrolling. In fact, you guys can all come to this group right here, the social real estate agent, and just look at all these. Look, I'll click on another one. As I click on this listing, she's bringing me to a full-blown website okay, so again, that's problem number one, full-blown website, too much stuff going on, all these distractions. Before you know it, I'm following her on LinkedIn. She just paid, let's say for example, that was an ad. She just paid to get me to click, come over to the page and follow her now on LinkedIn. It's like, dude, I didn't pay for that, right? We don't want that. We need them to freaking opt in. I need a lead. I don't need them following me on Twitter, right? I don't need any of that. So all this information up here, you guys, this is what you get with a fancy website. You guys don't need fancy websites. You need a freaking landing page. You need one page, a web page, right? So problem number one, again, you guys, too informative. Problem number two is that when you're now posting links, you want to make sure that the link is owned by you, not by Pack Realty, which is her broker, right? So you don't want the david.exprealty.com. I don't want to be promoting that link anywhere, like at all, because now where we're at now with the digital era that we're in, you guys, this is our damn near fingerprint. Like, this is our fingerprint, the link, our domain. We are building an audience around our domain, around our link. And on the back end, here's what's going on with Pack Realty. They're the ones, because that's their domain, they're the ones that have now the ability to put the Facebook pixel on the page. So as Nydia goes out there and works her ass off and promotes her listings, and she's just fired up about marketing and business, and she wants to post her links everywhere. Problem number two that I've seen 99% of the time is that it's the broker's Facebook pixel that is tracking all the activity. It's the broker's domain that is tracking all the activity. So here's what could happen. I doubt they do it, the brokers, but here's what easily can be done. Let's say I was Pack. I'm David Pack, right? I'm David Pack. This is my company, Pack Home Realty. And I got 50 agents on my team, right? I got 50 on my team. Nydia is one of them. As I give this cookie cutter replicated website, which is what all you guys have, is a cookie cutter replicated website from KW, from Coldwell. They're all the same. All agents have the same freaking website. As I go out there and give all 50 their own little website, yes, they could put their name up here in the front. Yes, yes, yes. But it's my domain. It's my domain. As I give my website to all of you guys, and you guys bust your balls to go promote it on social media, all fired up because you got a pretty little website. What I could do on the back end is, again, I have my Facebook pixel on everyone's page, and I have my link registered with Facebook to capture the data. So what I could do is I could turn around, start leveraging the data that all of my 50 agents are bringing in from their websites, and I can categorize that in my Facebook account and run ads to all those audiences. So as I click and come over to Nydia's page, her broker can turn around and show me an ad. Completely cut out Nydia. Now, I doubt they would do that. They're not going to, I don't think they would do that, but they can. It's easy. That's what Facebook is all about. The pixel and the data that's coming in from the visit, from the fact that someone visited on the page. So yes, the fact that I landed here, I am in their custom audience. So all they would do is turn around and show me another listing and completely cut out the agent. That's what's going on when you guys are promoting your websites. Like, you got to go to a landing page. Like, you got to go get your own software. Most of them run about $100 a month. The one I recommend, $100 a month. I'll put a link right below for a 14-day trial. But here's the difference. So rather than taking them to a click, right, a page that shows all of this crap going on, right, rather than doing all of that, here's how it should look. Here's the flow. So if I go from this ad right here, this link, I would be sending them to a simple landing page like this. Basic page. There's nothing going on at the top. There's no meet the team, contact us, directions to the office, 15 other listings. There's none of that crap, you guys. It's freaking one page, one blue button. That's it. This is your basic web page. This is your basic landing page. And again, these landing page software companies, most of them are about $100 a month. But if you're going to go out there and continue to build your business on social media, it's a wise investment. It's a wise investment, whether you guys are putting out organic posts or you're actually running ads. You need to be driving the click to a landing page. So let me show you the whole entire flow, and then we'll end it here. As I click, I would come straight to this one page, right? Few bullet points on the property. There's the one button. As that person opts in, name, email, phone number, right? As they opt in, send me the details. Instantly, an email is shot out, right? And then they land on this second page. Here is what I call the money page. This is the thank you page. This is your second page. This is where the money is at. As they land here, you guys, there's four bullet points that we would hit on in this simple 1 minute video. So jot this down or just make note. Number one, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for inquiring on my beautiful listing located at 123 Division Avenue. My name is David. I'm the listing agent of this beautiful property. Let me tell you a little bit more about it. So number one, I'm thanking them. Number two, I'm introducing myself. Number three, I'm saying check your email because I just emailed you all the details. So rather than giving me a list of everything right here on this page for free, you guys, no, like let me opt in. I got to opt in. See, now log in to get full access. See, so now you got to log in with Facebook. So this is, okay, perfect. So this might be the page that you're looking for. They don't give you too much access until you actually opt in. So that's actually a good thing right there. That was a good thing. But the majority of you guys, let's click on this next one. Look, full-blown website. So rather than doing all that, you guys, all of this information right here, the description, that's what I'm saying in the video. So as they just opted in, they landed here. I'm telling them in the video, check your email. I just sent you all the details. And that's what you want them to do, you guys. You want them to check your email and you want them to continue to check your emails. So number one, thank you. Number two, I'm introducing myself. Number three, I'm saying check your email because I just sent you all the details. And then number four, in this simple 1 minute video, I'm saying something like, hey guys, and by the way, this property is not going to last. I have five families coming by tonight. Everyone wants to see this property. Homes on the market are freaking moving. You're going to need to schedule your showing now. So click the button below. It'll take you straight to my calendar where you can schedule your private showing. And that's it, you guys. That is it. I took them straight from the post to them clicking to my one pager where they're opting in, landing on my second page where they're seeing me on video, which is the magic, right? You guys are here seeing me on video. This is the magic, right? So as they land here, boom, four bullet points, and then bam, I'm going for that call. And that is it, you guys. That is the flow. You got to be taking people to a landing page. And also, I'll end it here. You guys got to be running ads, man. You guys got to be running ads. Like, you guys got to be targeting your local area. Stop splatting content all over social media thinking that it's resonating with people. No, it's not. Okay, your cousins follow you and they're Facebook friends with you. Your uncle, your aunt, your in-laws, your husband. Okay, cool. Your core people that you know, I get it. But when you're scaling this friend count up, you guys, I got 5,000 agents over here. None of you guys live in San Diego. As we scale up our friend count on all these platforms, as I mentioned, no one lives in your area. So as you're posting, there's a reason why there's no engagement. And even in this group of 4,500 people, this person posted it April 7th. Today is April 20th. Shout out to all you 420ers out there. But this was posted on the 7th in a group of 4,500 people. And because I'm the admin, I get to view the insights. It reached 11. So those of you that are posting in groups thinking that, oh, this group has thousands of people, I'm going to freaking go and spam the hell out of it and try to get some leads out of it. No, dude, like that's not the way. Organic posting, and this primarily is for those of you that are building a local business. Again, if you're trying to farm a few zip codes, if you're promoting a listing that's in your area, an open house that's in your area, it's like, dude, run an ad. None of these friends are in that area. None of these friends care. Right? How many of you, keep it real, how many of you right now would care if I showed you an open house right now in San Diego? You guys are all across the country. Like, you don't care about my open house, like, coming up this weekend? You ain't coming, right? That's what's going on, you guys, as you scale up your friend count on all these platforms. None of these people are in the area. None of these people care. You got to run ads. So if this is making sense to any of you guys, I'd love to help you. Reach out to me. I teach real estate agents how to run Facebook ads, and I teach them how to put together these simple landing pages. I'll include a 14-day trial to the landing page that I've been recommending since 2018. It's the landing pages, your email autoresponder, and your online calendar. It's those three tools. It's the same $100 a month for everybody. But what this software comes with when people get involved with me and I start coaching them, it comes with me. So I have all these templates already done for you. I have a, if you're not promoting a listing, okay, then we would be promoting a seller guide, right? Simple one pager. Shout out to my client Oscar, my buddy Oscar, freaking kicking ass in the Ohio area. Let me share this again. Shout out to my buddy Oscar, right? Kicking ass. But when we're not running ads on a listing or an open house, we're running ads on a seller guide, targeting homeowners, targeting people that live in our backyard, right? Educating them on what it takes to sell, and then giving them a free seller guide. That's the bait. So you have to have an ethical bribe. You have to have either a buyer's guide or a seller guide to get people to click and want to download it, right? And it's the same flow with this one. Same one pager. Click here to download your free copy. As that person opts in, they land on your second page where it's number one, thank you. Number two, introduce yourself. Number three, check your email because I just sent over your PDF, your free seller guide. You're going to love it. Check your email right away. And then number four, I'm going for the call. And that's it, you guys. So get your hands on some software. Some landing pages is where we're at in 2023 and beyond. No more websites. Reach out to me. I'd love to help you. I have all these funnels already done. The seller guide one, the listing one. Activate a 14-day trial. There's a link right here, right below. Activate a 14-day trial, and I will give you these funnels for free. The open house one. This open house one, here's another open house one, super, super basic, super simple and clean. That's all it takes, you guys, to capture that open house lead. They land on the second page. It'd be you on video hitting the same four bullet points. So activate a 14-day trial or just reach out to me, guys. I want to teach how to run these ads, how to target your local area, and how to capture more leads than you can even think that's possible. Okay, you guys. So stay connected. Activate a 14-day trial, and I'll see you on my next video. Over and out.